I'm Lou Ann Hammond with at drivingthenation.com, and I'm here with Victor Mueller, the founder of Spyker Motors and the owner of Saab Motor Cars.
That's definitely true.
Yes. So I just think it's great that you actually started Spyker yourself.
From scratch. 10 years ago.
What made you do such a crazy thing?
Well, actually, that's the answer. I'm completely crazy. And you have to be a little bit crazy to do that sort of thing. But I felt I was buying new Ferraris, new Aston Martins at the time, and I thought, you know, I didn't like their fit and finish. I can do this better. And, of course, I had no idea what I was getting into, right?
Yeah, so instead of spending a couple million, you thought you'd spend a lot more millions?
Well, you know, there's a classic rule in the car trade, right? How do you end up with a small fortune in the car business? You start with a big one.
That's right.
And and that's exactly what I did. So now I have a small fortune. But I own Saab.
And what are you doing with Saab?
Well, we're completely revamping the brand. Of course, it's been going through hell. It was part of a sales process. It went through a Chapter 11 situation. It went through voluntary liquidation, all in the time that GM owned it.
Right.
And then fortunately, we could buy it. And that deal was concluded on the 23rd of February this year. And the next big thing, of course, is going to be the launch of the new Saab 9-3 in October 2012. So, strange as it may seem, Saab is a completely revived company.
Victor, you started Spyker 10 years ago, so you know its entire history.
True.
You know what your customers really love about the Spyker. But Saab was started many, many years before.
And I'm pretty old, even before I was born.
So are you trying to keep any of the sort of four-banger history, legacy, the airplane side of
Absolutely,
Saab?
Yes. The most valuable thing about the Saab brand is its heritage. And I think if it lost anything under the GM stewardship was its brand DNA. And as a Spyker creator, it's all about heritage, right? So we are definitely pushing very hard to bring this brand DNA back. And that's what you'll see with the new 9-3. That car, I mean, with your eyes closed, you'll be able to see, now that's a Saab. And this Saabishness, as we call it, has to be brought back with a vengeance. And that's exactly what we're doing. So the real advantages are in distribution, Spyker and Saab sharing distribution,
right.
Parts, commonality of parts, engineering, Saab having the most phenomenal engineering in the trade, and of course a lot of events and marketing where you can share the infrastructure.
Do you look, Spyker also is known though for like power to weight ratio,
yes,
those
exactly
type of things. That. Are you looking at that for Saab?
Well, clearly a Saab buyer is much less interested in a power to weight ratio than, for instance, in fuel economy.
Mm-hmm.
Saab is a very green company. It's very much driven by responsible performance. It's a car that's wonderful to drive, yet you don't burn up, you know, too much gas. And that is really where we're focusing on. The element of bringing your fuel consumption down clearly is weight reduction. And this is the name of the game. Weight reduction, downsizing engines, turboing them, those things are the order of the day.
Tell us something that most people don't know about you.
I'm a keen bird watcher.
Oh.
Yeah. Runs in my family.
Where do you live?
I live in Mallorca, in Spain.
Okay, so there are quite a few birds there.
My garden
birds.
Is filled with birds.
Yeah. Victor Mueller, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.